is a CBS News special report. I'm Anthony Mason in New York, where stocks on Wall Street plummeted again this morning because of coronavirus concerns. The Dow Jones Industrials fell more than 9% right after the opening bell, as you can see, down 9.71%, almost 10%, which means trading was automatically stopped for 15 minutes. That's the third time that's happened in the past 2 weeks and in the past several trading days. This follows the Federal Reserve's surprise decision yesterday to slash interest rates to nearly 0% in an effort to limit economic damage from the worldwide pandemic. Weijia Zhang is at the White House, where President Trump praised the Fed move yesterday. Weijia, good morning.
Good morning, Anthony, and to everybody. This is absolutely crushing for the economy. There is no other way to put it. And it's exactly what President Trump did not want and did not expect, Anthony, because as you mentioned, the Fed cut its benchmark rate yesterday by a full percentage point to now the range of 0 to 0.25%. And President Trump made remarks almost immediately after. In fact, it was happening, and he came here to the White House briefing room, and he told Americans that this was a time almost to celebrate. He said people and the markets should be thrilled. And of course, we have just seen that is not what has happened at all. And a lot of experts point to the reason being the president's other messages. He has sent mixed messages about what is actually unfolding with regard to the coronavirus. He insists that people should remain calm and relaxed, while his medical experts are standing next to him warning that the worst has yet to come and that people should brace themselves for how much impact this virus could have. And what we've seen, Anthony, from day one is that the president has been extremely fixated on how this virus and its spread is impacting the economy. And after he held a press conference in the Rose Garden last week on Friday, the very next morning he actually came out and said he was honored to see that the markets were rebounding. Well, that's because during his remarks then, he had finally embraced the medical aspect and the public health piece of all of this that his advisors had been urging him to do instead of talking so much about the economy. But again, yesterday he came out, he congratulated the Fed for cutting the interest rate. He said this is going to be a big boost, and the opposite has now happened. And this, of course, adds to the anxiety, frankly, that many people are feeling about where their money is going. We know that today Congress is also taking steps. The Senate is expected to take up a House bill that already passed, which is an emergency funding package for people to offer paid sick leave, to help feed families, especially those kids who are now out of school, and to boost the economy. But Anthony, this is a very dire message. The Fed signaled that when it cut its interest rate. And now we are all just seeing, you know, what unfolds for the rest of the day. But so far, we have not heard from President Trump.
Yeah. All right, Weijia, thank you. Yeah, one of the concerns here, I think a lot of people will be surprised that the market dropped so sharply after the Fed's decision. I mean, and one of the problems here now is that the Federal Reserve, having dropped interest rates to zero, essentially, Weijia, has nothing more that it can do. It's got effectively no more bullets in its arsenal to use, and that's leaving things pretty vulnerable. We're joined now on the phone by CBS News business analyst Jill Schlesinger. Jill, are you surprised by the sharpness of this drop?
Well, unfortunately not, since I've been up all night watching the futures markets. And here's what the problem is right now. The Federal Reserve has done exactly what it is supposed to do. It is supposed to make sure that the financial plumbing of the financial system is operational. And that's what they're doing. They do that by cutting rates. They do that by making sure that lending is available to individuals and businesses. And it does that by making sure that all the global banks around the world have access to U.S. dollars. What the Federal Reserve cannot do is stop the negative consequences of the spread of this virus. And that is what's happening. You know, Anthony, I liken it to we're driving down the highway, we're going 55 miles an hour. Things are kind of fine. That's where we were in the beginning of this year. We have now slammed on the brakes, and we are in a wild skid. We don't know where we end up, and that is causing so many problems in the big economy, but also in the markets.
Yeah, in the meantime, we're seeing the economic consequences of this continually play out, and it's not clear, Jill, just how broad those are going to be. I mean, I was just across the street getting a cup of coffee. There were two customers in there when typically at this hour there are 10. They'd taken all the chairs and all the seating out because no one's supposed to congregate, and everybody but the guy in the counter was like, we don't know what's going to be happening here.
That's right. And I think that that's really the problem, is the uncertainty that we're all feeling. Of course, we feel uncertain about our own health and our family's health. That's one level. And then you drill down to the economic uncertainty, to the nearly one third of the folks in this country who work in the private sector who don't have paid sick leave, to hourly employees who are going to see either hours reduced or even layoffs. This is where we need the government to come in and take action. And that's why a lot of traders were somewhat disheartened by the fact that we didn't get a bigger, broader deal in Washington, D.C., from the federal government to help ease the pain of individuals and small businesses.
All right, Jill Schlesinger, thank you. Once again, trading halted on Wall Street as the Dow falls nearly 10% at the open. There is a 15-minute break when trading will resume after that. If it falls another 6%, trading will be suspended again. If it drops 20% for the day, then trading will be halted entirely for the day. Our coverage will continue on our 24-hour streaming network CBSN. You can watch it at cbsnews.com or on our CBS News app. There will be more to come on your local news on this CBS station and tonight on the CBS Evening News with Nora O'Donnell. This has been a CBS News special report. I'm Anthony Mason, CBS News, New York.
For news 24 hours a day, go to cbsnews.com.